So today I'm gonna try something different. I am going to record at 1080p, not 4K, at 60 frames per second on my Sony a6500. And we are going to the Apple store to pick up one of the two laptops I left there last week. I have the keys to my car somewhere. I have the keys to my vehicle, booster board. And I'm gonna ride into the city, probably over the Williamsburg Bridge again. I'm going to the Apple store in Williamsburg, so I'm gonna ride through Williamsburg into the Williamsburg Bridge, over the Williamsburg Bridge, and probably either to the Soho area or to the Freedom Tower. This little young thing here is not going to ride today. She's gonna leave me alone and riding. And there's tons of electric city bikes today. But even if we do find an electric city bike, we can't because we have a
minor
or a follower or a tag along, a third wheel. And maybe I'm going to stop at Blue Bottle Coffee and get that coffee. I mean, the machine, the bottle for cold brew and cold brew, whatever you call that, grounds already made for cold brew. But it's $20, depending on how much the bottle is. The bottle got to be more than 20. I may or may not get it. All right. See you guys in a bit. Watch it. There's poop all over.
I was hoping that they say, let me switch the tab too.
Okay. Whose computer is that?
Mine.
Listen, North 11 has a pedal assist city bike, but too bad. Okay, so we made it to the car. We got our computer. I am going to probably ride to the Freedom Tower through the Williamsburg Bridge over the FDR. They're gonna be staying here and sitting down at some shop, I don't know. All right, it's time to go over the Williamsburg Bridge. Hey, happy Sunday, guys. I know I'm kind of doing a intro again, but this is not the same day or the same vlog as the previous vlog because I never made it over the Williamsburg Bridge, and I'll tell you why. And I reached out to a few people on Reddit and New York City e-boarding to find out some tips and advice as to my fail. And my failed attempt, I mean, like you guys saw, I was going up the Williamsburg Bridge like I did the previous week. And from the Brooklyn to Manhattan side, there's a big gap for the bridge, I guess, to expand and kind of contract during cold and summer months. And I decided to pick up speed as I was going up the incline, and I went maybe about 15, 16, 18 miles per hour. But there was that big metal gap and I was staring at it. And again, I'm new to skateboarding, so the metal gap
kind of goes like this, I would say, where there's like a indent and it's, you know, maybe like this wide. So as I'm going with my skateboard, my booster board stuff, I'm going, I just saw myself kind of, I went straight ahead, by the way, and I saw myself just go down into the hole and never bounce back up. And of course I saw my life in front of me in slow motion about, you know, 15 seconds, not even 5 seconds, 2 seconds. I was flying and I slid. I didn't get hurt. And I wasn't wearing gloves. The gloves, I bought some flatland 3D gloves and I wasn't wearing them, but I didn't get hurt either. What did get hurt was I was carrying this Sony A6500 on my mini tripod, and this got hurt. The lens, the Sony lens, it's completely broken. It actually popped out. I dropped the camera. But it's no biggie. These lenses are, you know, this is a Sony Self, CELP 1650. It's a cheap lens that comes with the Sony kit. It is a 16 or 50 millimeter, I think a f-stop of 3.5 is the lowest it goes. But I was able to go on eBay the same day and bought a pre-owned one for like $60 just to kind of replace it. I do have a Sigma that I like to use. Thank God I wasn't using that one. That one is a little bit more expensive, a lot more actually. But learned my lesson. So like I said, I posted it on Reddit. I posted it on New York City e-boarding. And everyone's told me to go and hit that metal gap, if you will, at an angle, or to kind of bounce off your board. So I've been looking forward to practicing that on the Williamsburg Bridge. Hopefully I don't fall again. The weather is kind of getting crappy in New York City. It's getting cold. Today, actually, the following Sunday, since that ride, you know, last week it was like 62 degrees on Sunday. This week is 45 and extremely windy. Wind gusts up to 40 miles per hour. So I didn't go ride. But I do look forward to another 60 degree day before we hit November and December. And I look forward to riding my booster board on the Williamsburg Bridge and trying to hit it at an angle, or if not, hopping. Let me know what your comments or concerns are in the comments below. If you do ride in New York City in the Williamsburg Bridge, on the Williamsburg Bridge, or any other bridge that has those metal gaps, what is the best way to kind of learn to go over that gap? I don't commute in my booster board, but I do like the Williamsburg area, Greenpoint area of Brooklyn as of recent, and riding over into Lower East Side of Manhattan. There's a lot of, you know, coffee shops, a lot of little bars, a lot of great little things that you can catch just by riding. So sorry I wasn't able to upload the full video. I did have a GoPro mounted on my helmet, but I mounted a GoPro session backwards, so it was facing the back of my helmet, so you couldn't really see anything. So I guess it wasn't a day for me to ride. But thank you guys for watching. I'll end it here. Like I said, please like, please comment below what's the best way to kind of hit that gap, if you will, on the booster board or any electric skateboard or longboard. Looking forward to your comments and suggestions. Also, if you can link any videos of, you know, tutorials, that would be great as well. Again, I'm new to this and looking forward to learning, become an expert, if you will, at skateboarding and, most importantly, booster board. Thank you guys. Later.